How does it feel to be a part of this year's festival?
Well, exciting, you know, because this is great horror festival with very big horror fans audience. You know, I love when I present a movie in to an audience full of real fans, you know. And all the crew of the festival are friends of mine, and for me it's really, really exciting to be here.
And can you just give fans a quick synopsis of your film? Tell us a little bit about the story.
Well, the movie is about a doorman, apparently a gentle, quiet doorman during the day, but actually when night arrives, he becomes evil. And he tries, hidden in the night, he tries to torment all of the neighbors, you know. And well, that's the beginning of the plot, at the start of plot, and then things could be more horrible, and it the whole thing becomes a nightmare.
Where did the inspiration come from the story?
Well, you should ask to the screenwriter because he invented the story. But he told me like 4 years ago he was in New York trying to rent an apartment, and he realized that the doorman in New York, people taking care about the buildings, are really, really powerful, you know, and respected. And he was disturbed about that idea, and he decided to write a story. When I received the script, I was really shocked because apparently it is a very typical story, an evil guy trying to torment an innocent girl. This is something we've seen a thousand of times. But surprisingly, that story is told in a completely different way. The point of view of the story is the point of view of the evil guy, not the point of view of the girl, of the innocent girl. And the audience is obliged, and me, when I was reading the script, I was obliged to be in the side, to participate with the evil guy in all his plans and his strategies. And it was really, really shocking, and it has a potential of suspense, really, really, really important.
I mean, you mentioned that it's very rare to see in the horror genre. So often we're in the position of the victim, not the person doing the terrible things. Did that influence the way you approach from the way you directed, the way you positioned the camera, those kind of decisions?
Well, of course. It always depends the way you direct the movie. All the decisions you make are depending of the point of view and of what you are expecting for the audience. I was expecting for the audience to have this moral conflict and to be in the side of him. So all the decisions in order to direct the movie were made in this direction.
I mean, we're here at Fright Fest celebrating the best in horror. I guess the obvious question is, what do you think it is that the horror genre gives audiences that they don't get from any other genre? Why do people love horror so much?
Well, I think people like horror because fear is an emotion, but the human being have this emotion, fear, just to survive, you know. But actually, in modern times, we don't need exactly fear to survive because we live in a very safe, not everybody, of course, but we live in a very safe society. So fear is a not used emotion, you know what I mean? And that's the reason that people like to have this emotion excited, you know? Of course, I have thousands of favorite horror movies, but I can tell you movies like The Thing, John Carpenter's The Thing, The Exorcist. I love a movie from like 8 years ago called Wolf Creek, an Australian movie. It scared me, really. But plenty of them. Poltergeist.
So many good ones.
Aliens.
So many fantastic films. We have to let you go now, but final question. Do you have a message to horror fans? Is there anything you'd like to say to them about this film, your film?
Yes, I would like them to see the movie and participate in this game. They are invited to participate in this game, to choose their side. And I hope they make a good choice, of course.